Welcome everyone to this webinar about how you can accelerate development with the new i.MX 8 QuadMax and Quad Plus processor presented by Toradex and our partner NXP. As we're still having a few people dialing in, I have a couple logistical items. If you have any questions during the webinar, please post your question in the chat window of your GoToWebinar panel. You may do so at any time during the presentation. We will also have a few polls to make this webinar a little bit more interactive for you attending. And we'll have a Q&A session at the end to then answer all your questions that have been posted. For those I can't get to the questions, we'll follow up via email and make sure that you all get your questions answered, even though if we don't get to them. Also, a recording of this webinar will be made available within 1 week on the Toradex website and on our YouTube channel also. So now let's get started and dive in. First of all, let me introduce who is with me today. I have Pat Steelwell from NXP. He is the product marketing manager for the i.MX 8 QuadMax and Quad Plus family at NXP. And my name is Samuel Imgruth. I'm the global CEO at Toradex, and I'm pleased to be hosting this session with you guys today. Our agenda will first quickly have a very short introduction of Toradex and what we're doing, followed by NXP talking about their new i.MX 8 QuadMax application processor. Then we'll look a little bit into how Toradex incorporated the i.MX 8 in a system of module family from the Apalis line. And we will talk about operating systems and software solutions, as well as partner ecosystems around the i.MX 8 platforms. Finally, we'll highlight a couple special features such as the heterogeneous multicore and functional safety aspect that the i.MX 8 QuadMax processor brings, followed by a live Q&A session at the end. So what does Toradex do? We design, manufacture, and sell industrial-grade, off-the-shelf embedded computing products, primarily focusing on ARM system and modules. We provide best-in-class ease of use and reliability together with free lifetime product maintenance and industry-leading technical support. This all leads to the total lowest cost of ownership, allowing customers to focus on their own value add and assure market success. We're a global company, as you can see here on the map. We have offices in Europe, North America, South America, as well as Asia. Now we'll continue with a quick poll and to see who of you guys are all aware of and using i.MX processors. Please cast your votes in the next couple seconds here. I can see some results coming in. All right, I see most of the results are in. So we have almost 60% of you are familiar or using the i.MX 6 family. We have about 18% already working with i.MX 8. That's great. And about 16% with i.MX 7. About 30% are using other i.MX 8 products from NXP, and about a third of you has no current exposure for product line from NXP. Thanks for sharing that. So let's go on. I would like to introduce here NXP with me today, as announced, is Pat. He will take you through an overview of the i.MX 8 QuadMax application processor before we then follow on and dive a little bit deeper into some of the ecosystem offerings around the process. Without further ado, Pat, please go ahead.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Sam. Welcome, everybody. Good afternoon. Thanks for joining the call. Pat Stowell, the i.MX 8 QuadMax Quad Plus product line manager. And I'm just going to go into some slight details on the launch of our i.MX 8 application processors that we are beginning to introduce to the mass markets. And certainly with Toradex being one of our long-term partners and with their enhanced ecosystem in place, we're really able to reach out to a multitude of customers that otherwise we probably wouldn't reach really from a corporate level on our side. So really good news for the i.MX 8 from automotive qualification. We have past qualification here over the last month or so. And secondly, from an industrial side, the industrial qualification will be complete. Actually, it'll be this week. And then we will have all of our documentation in respect to data sheet and errata coming over the next couple of weeks. As you can see, December 5th is actually our target. And we're really excited about that. Really, the extended readpoint of industrial is what pushes it out a couple of extra weeks. So really, from a reliability standpoint, that's due to that case. And then for all of our production shipments, for any of you who have ordered any of our parts, we are now scheduling all these M-qualified part numbers that are currently in backlog. So if anybody on the call has made some of them orders, you should start seeing some schedules that are taking place in respect to that. And then for additional information on the i.MX 8 family, we do have a product summary fact sheet that's on nxp.com. I do have a couple of hyperlinks on here that you can go to. And again, with product documentation, we have our data sheet for both QuadMax and QuadPlus from an automotive perspective on the website, along with the errata. And then we do have reference manuals coming, but the final reference manual will be published in probably early to mid-January. And this is due to the fact we're still finalizing some of our testing for the industrial qualification. And we do have to make some updates to the reference manual. And really, with it being a 5,000-6,000 page reference manual, we really only want to do that one time. So, but it's still going to be available. You would contact me directly if you wanted access to this reference manual, and I would direct you to a SharePoint as long as you're under, working with us on some of your projects. So if you have an NDA with us, I can more likely just give you access to the extranet. And then, of course, everything else that falls onto our summary page with our evaluation board documentation, the hardware itself, schematics, BSDL files, and a lot of our partner SOMs, of course, including Toradex on there as well. So really, again, we're really excited to have this ready to go to market. And mass market launch is in January. Of course, Toradex is ahead of that, being one of our partners, go-to market partners. And so we're ready to start implementing this into the marketplace. So just a quick historical perspective. I know a lot of you online, certainly with that last polling, are very familiar with the i.MX 6 family, as you can see. And really, a lot of the feedback over the years is really customers using, based on our pin-to-pin compatibility amongst the family, as well as software compatibility around the whole family. And then really are the typical migration from the i.MX 6 into the i.MX 8 and i.MX 7 family. This would be your migration to help enhance your product lines. On the bottom with the i.MX 7 family, of course, this is really one of our new low power, high efficient connectivity families with the 7 dual and the 7 solo. And then of course, a much aligned 7 ULP with our really very low power numbers with a graphical interface. Really this falls into like the wearables type market when it comes to the 7 ULP. Again, very established, launched over the summer, I believe, to expand into our i.MX family roadmap. And then on top, the i.MX 8 family, which includes the 8QuadMax and QuadPlus that we're talking about today, which comes with dual A72s, 4 A53 A cores, a couple of M4s, multiple GPUs as well. And I'll get into that in a little bit. And then on the bottom, the 8X family. This is what I would call like our mid-range family with the A35 A cores with a couple of M4s on it as well. So that's the differentiation between the i.MX 8 and the 8X are the A cores that are used in the clusters. And then the middle 8 family there, the 8M family, this is our high-end advanced audio video family that some of you may or may not be familiar with. And the 8 mini and the 8 nano fall under this umbrella. So really it's advanced audio video and then for the 8M family. And then when you talk about the 8X and the 8 family, this is high-end, high compute advanced graphical interfacing, if that's what your needs are at this point. So secondly, again, from a scalable solution side, I did go into a little bit of detail with the 8M family from audio video side, and then the 8X and the 8M family. Really, again, high performing applications which are needed between the 8X and the 8. It's over 70% of the hardware and software reuse. It's pin-to-pin compatibility within their respective families. So talking about the 8QuadMax today and Quad Plus, we also have a third family coming on our roadmap for the Dual Max, as you can see there. So again, we're continually to advance our roadmap and within each respective family themselves. And then this is a good one pager. You can see from the i.MX 8 family on the left, the 8QuadMax, Quad Plus, and you can see the A53, A72s, the different clusters that are in there. In each one of these families also has a DSP on chip. So really this goes towards your saving on your BOM materials if you are able to utilize the DSP for whatever audio needs you may need. A couple of GPUs on the 8QuadMax, which is really what we call our superset part, our high-end part. A couple of display controllers, two M4s to take care of any of your, really the M4s, these MCUs can offload some of the tasks that may previously have been used on the application processor. So again, you could take advantage of that. And then the multiple MIPI CSIs for multiple cameras, and the QuadMax can run multiple displays, up to four displays at a time, with one of the displays being a 4K HDMI. And then moving down to the right, the Dual Max, you can kind of see there in the middle on the left, which we'll be launching. It's probably about a year and a half out, but we're already going into our final design for the 8 Dual Max. And then the 8X family that I talked about previously with the 8QXP family, and then also the 8DX, and then new down to the right, this is on our roadmap for the 8X family, the pin-to-pin compatibility, which is going to be targeted towards some industrial type gateways, those type of designs that don't need any kind of DSP audio features, utilizing the DSP or a major graphical interface. So this is, as you can see, a chopped down version of the 8X. Again, this just tells the story of the scalability within the i.MX 8X and 8 family themselves. So along within the NXP themselves, really what we do is we leverage our end-to-end secure systems within all of our families themselves. And really what this means, it's really from the edge computing all the way up through the cloud, no matter what your business may or may not be. Within the SoCs themselves, we have hardware security features that are implemented in a lot of our products. We take advantage of NXP's knowledge within the security industry. And this can be in respect to smart cards or along with software for any kind of payment transactions that take place. We've shipped over 10 billion units in smart cards, as well as reader modules that are all over the world in the different regions. So we're taking advantage of this know-how on some of these MCUs, and we've implemented all this knowledge into the i.MX 8 family. And this includes the secure boot, as you can see on the wheel here, some of our secure storage implementation that takes place, our tamper detection, both from a software and hardware level. We have multiple tamper detect pins, and then from a software level at the same time, we can detect any kind of intrusion that may take place with a hacker. You know, it could be side channel attacks or low voltage. So you can detect low voltage, over voltage applications that may be taking place from an outside hacker. And then of course, with the i.MX 8, our hardware strong partitioning, virtualization within the chip itself, where we make sure that some of these bits and transactions that take place can only be written to certain areas of the chip, certainly within the memory interface. And then, of course, key management and key protection for those who are looking to have secure keys installed on their systems. And we can have this, we have this implemented in our manufacturing process, you know, with secure servers and everything in place in case this is what customers are requiring as well. So several different options depending on how you want to manage your security settings or security devices in the future. And then for qualification specifications for the i.MX family, for the i.MX 8, both automotive and industrial qualification. As you can see on the bottom for industrial, we have a 10-year life expectancy for operating life. And this really is with 100% on all the time, 100% duty cycle. And you can see our TJ temperature range there from -40 to 105. So this is with some really extreme cases, which I believe some of the applications Toradex and yourselves are working on fit into this model. And then, of course, from the automotive side, meeting a 15-year life cycle at a minimum. And this is typical with a 10% always on. Really in automotive space, 10% where your car is always operating is typical when it falls into that range of duty cycle. So again, from an industrial standpoint, 100% on, and this is part of our reliability structure and testing as we go through our qualification. And then from a safety and a reliability, really the i.MX 8 is built on some of our functional safety mechanisms that we've implemented from a hardware perspective into the part. Running the manufacturing process of 28 nanometer FDSOI for its reliability features. We also have parity checks in the L1 caches and ECC and the L2 caches within the chip itself. And then of course, with the M4s that are currently on the SoC, with TCM has ECC on them as well to meet any of your functional safety needs for any checks or monitorings that need to take place, certainly from a memory side. And then DDR memory on DDR3L has ECC on that bus. And just really with our failover displays and cameras from a functional safety needs, and this can be both not only in automobile but in manufacturing and industrial applications as well. So again, from an industrial side of the i.MX 8 family, this is again a high level snapshot of the offering of the 8QuadMax. Of course, the DSP that I talked to, up to 4 displays that can be offered in parallel, LVDS, MIPI DSI, and then a couple of M4 Cortex M cores, 4 A53s and 2 A72s. And then as you can see, as we scale down to the Quad Plus, one of the A72s are removed. And of course, if this fits into your different solutions, you can take advantage of it by having different product lines as needed, depending on the performance that is required. And then on the bottom, the 8 Dual Max, we take out all those A53s, and this may fall even better into your power budgets if required, as you start designing some of your end products, you know, with some of these Toradex SOMs that are currently in place. And then target markets for the i.MX 8, certainly from an automotive perspective, we have electronic e-cockpits coming to some vehicles near you in the future, along with heads-up displays. And really from an industrial and building and home automation, really it's these high-end HMI interfacing and control mechanisms that can be designed. And of course, machine learning, object classification, vision recognition and response, AI, and computer or surround views, and any other kind of industrial environmental monitoring that takes place nowadays. And this could go make it much easier if some of these designs are really remotely placed, which can still, you can still monitor some of your hardware and applications that are in place. And of course, from a security side, multiple domain security systems, we have a HSM on the chip that your team can take advantage of as well. And then again, industrial applications, machine learning, vision, robotics, industrial printers, room monitoring, falling into avionics placement and displays, and of course, some fitness equipment that we've been designed into, as well as other factory automation that can take place. And really, this all falls into what I discussed earlier with not only the longevity of the product lines for availability from a sourcing perspective, but extreme operating conditions from a reliability-wise, duty cycle-wise, and of course our security implementations that can you be able to take advantage of. And then of course safety and reliability. It could be from just a safety side or really functional safety that gets built into the overall solution and platform. And then from an EIQ machine learning functionalities on our product and some of our offerings using some of our machine learning management skills and inference engines that are available along with the accelerators and taking advantage of multiple GPUs. This EIQ development platform is one of the offerings that is currently available from NXP. And Toradex themselves certainly take advantage of this. I believe Sam will talk about that in a little bit. But this is really one of the major offerings that customers can come to us, whether it's from an industrial side, working with all of our partners to implement this into your final drafts. And then again, this is just a nice block diagram, which shows all the different connectivity features. You can see on the right, far right over there, multiple 1 gigabit Ethernet, USB 2, USB 3 offerings, PCIe, SATA, and then multiple screens, as I talked about, and then from a security level, high assurance boot and using ARM Trust Zone, and then tamper detect, and of course, ECC flashless SHE. So really all the offerings that we hope meets all of our customers' needs when it comes to the i.MX 8 and the Quad Plus. And then just real quick, I wanted to hit on, you know, when it comes to some of our functional safety, our Safe Assure program that we have from an NXP initiative really targets a lot of, for the i.MX 8, the ASIL-A and ASIL-B targeted hardware. So customers could take full advantage of this and display any kind of failover capable needs that we offer. And we also have teams here in place at NXP that can help with any kind of software solutions that may be needed for your functional safety plans. And then real quick, I just wanted to put this on here that in case any of you actually do order directly from us from some of your distributors for some of your R&D efforts, we do have production part numbers in place to order. Now that we have launched those sample part numbers on the bottom, we'll probably go end of life here over the next 6 months because we are in full production. So just keep that in mind, but currently they still are available. So again, these are available to order, and in case you do have any orders on the books, that backlog should be filled quickly when it comes to that. And then Sam, I think that's all I have from an NXP side.
Thank you so much, Pat, for that comprehensive introduction. Now let's talk a little bit about how we at Toradex actually have taken the new i.MX 8 QuadMax processor and actually incorporated that in one of our Apalis SOM product lines. I trust that most of you are familiar with the concept of a system on module that basically encapsulates the processor, memory, usually the flash storage, connectivity, typically wireless connectivity options, power management, and then some of the supporting circuits around the processor, while bringing out all the typical and available IOs, such as multiple displays, camera interfaces, dual gigabit Ethernet, USB 3, PCIe, and SATA on the connector, basically making it easier for customers to incorporate such a complex high-performance processor such as the i.MX 8QuadMax into their embedded or industrial products. So we at Toradex, we really, focus on an entire product family. So if we're looking at the Apalis family on the top, which we're bringing i.MX 8QuadMax to, we have several pin-compatible products. Like NXP, their chips, their processor, and their software offerings compatible within the family. We at Toradex do the same, but on the level of the actual system on modules. So that allows you, if you already have a system on module from Toradex deployed today or have been evaluating one, you can very easily upgrade thanks to the pin compatibility. Then on the bottom, you can also see our other product line, the Colibri family, which we don't talk about. Well, we have been bringing i.MX 8X, the other product Pat quickly mentioned, to that family, but this is not something we'll be talking about today. Very important also, we do incorporate certified wireless solution on all the new products. So also on the connectivity side, you have fully certified 802.11 AC, a 2x2 wireless and Bluetooth 5 solution on the module. Now, if you look at a comparison of the products in our Apalis family, on the very left-hand side, you have our highest performance module, of course, based on the i.MX 8QuadMax processor, running a cluster of 6A cores, an additional 2 MCU cores, 4 GB of RAM, 16 gigs of flash memory. And again, for those of you who maybe have an i.MX 6 based product deployed in our Apalis family, this is a direct upgrade and replacement in case you are sticking to the standard pinouts that we have defined in the Apalis family. Now, today, Toradex already offers 4 standard SKU. You can find those on our website. So one thing that we focus on the Toradex side are standard off-the-shelf products. So these are manufactured to stock, which you can buy from us. For those of you who have been part of the early access program with i.MX 8, you have already been able to order some of the early samples. And we really have two groups of i.MX 8 SOMs that we're offering, one based on the i.MX 8 QuadMax, our high-end product line. That one also includes the DSP that Pat mentioned. If you have audio type applications, we have that feature enabled. And then you can buy those SKUs either with or without Wi-Fi populated. Very important also on our highest end SKU, we do feature the full industrial range, -40 plus 85C, to really tailor to those demanding high performance applications that really align with the placement of the i.MX 8 processor. On the lower end side, or I would say more mid-range side, we have the Quad Plus variant. Same thing, a little bit less memory, fully pin compatible, but only spec'd in this case for extended temp -25. This should still be suitable for most of your applications. Now, with every system of modules, you will be needing a carrier board. Toradex actually offers directly two carrier boards, off-the-shelf carrier boards that help you kickstart your evaluation. We have a hardware development port, the bigger one that you see here, and then we have a software development board, our Xora board, what we call it, which can also be used in an actual volume product. Those are ready-to-go boards. And again, if some of you are already familiar with the Apalis system module family, you might have those boards, so there's no upgrade needed there. You can simply just add the new i.MX 8 QuadMax based SOM and you're ready to go. We also offer tooling to assure compatibility and let you guys check on the peripheral pins. So if you want to make sure that your existing carrier board is compatible with i.MX 8, you can use our pinout designer to validate. In addition to the boards that Toradex provide, we work with our partners to offer third-party carrier boards. Here on the right-hand side, you actually see an i.MX 8 QuadMax Smart Vision Kit from the company and partner Antmicro. And then we are also excited to share that we're working with Gumsticks and their Chipetto-based web carrier board design tool Geppetto is an online tool that lets you design and order your custom carry board with out of your web browser. So that's very cool, and it really accelerates your development time frame or just the prototype phase of your i.MX 8 product development. Now, of course, operating systems is one of probably the most important support aspect on the ecosystem side. Toradex does provide what we like to call a production quality Linux PSP, which we traditionally build with the Okta project. That's your typical embedded Linux PSP. This is the ideal starting point for those of you who like customizing their embedded Linux and build a custom image specifically tailored to your needs. You receive free support from Toradex. All the PSP source code is available open source from Toradex. And you can actually also track all the features and potential open box or issues on our website. So this is very helpful. It gives you good visibility on known problems or what we're working on here. So we're fully transparent there. And for those of you who actually have contacted Toradex before, you may know we have a community for support reasons, which is moderated by our FAs, solution architects, or the actual development engineers that work on our Linux PSPs. So you do get firsthand qualified technical support from us. In addition to the traditional embedded Linux PSP, Toradex has been working on an actual Linux distribution. Our Torizon software platform is an easy to use industrial Linux, and it's actually built, the operating system is built based on Linux micro platforms. And underlies underneath is the same Yocto open embedded BSP that our traditional Linux is offering. So we're sharing the same code base. It's available fully open source for you guys. Torizon comes with a Docker container runtime that really plays into the ease of use. So you can very quickly deploy your applications or customize your image. So it's really, we really try to simplify the use of Linux with offering a binary and containerized Linux distribution here. Torizon also includes a full automotive grade upgrade system. So we have an OTA capability built in that allows you for frequent and secure updates. And for those of you who are in the industrial space, we do also provide variants that have been optimized for real time. So this is a very exciting offering that on the software side that we have been working on Toradex. If you're interested, please feel free to check out more resources on our website, and we have a dedicated webinar recorded on this. Now, in addition to the traditional Linux offerings, we also offer Android here. We have a trusted partner, Kinetics, who builds the Android images for Toradex and supports our customers. These evaluation images you actually can deploy with Toradex Easy Installer, which is our launcher tool I will be talking a little bit about later, and the source code, most importantly, the source code for our Android i.MX 8 Android images is available for free for those of you who like to work with Android. Last but not least, also on the real-time side, we do have some special offerings with QNX. We're actually working directly with QNX to develop a PSP, reference PSP for our i.MX 8 system and module. And then we also work with Greenhouse for the same, for their integrity offerings. Those PSP will be provided shortly through our website and promoted, and the support is available directly from these partners. So feel free to contact us if these are the operating systems you like to work with. Now let's quickly look at what type of operating system you guys traditionally use in your embedded device. So we have a quick poll for that. Looks like a close race between the Okta project and Linux distributions. I'll give a couple more seconds here. Okay, I see the results are in. We have about 60% of you use Linux, embedded Linux on the Okta project side. We have about 50% use a Linux distribution such as Debian, Ubuntu, and so on. And about 10% like to use a different type of operating system. Very few of you use Android or Windows 10 IT4. Thanks for sharing that. Now let's go on. I talked quickly a little bit about our out-of-the-box experience. So we provide a fully pre-installed tool called Toradex Easy Installer, which we factory install with all our i.MX 8 system of modules. So when you first start up one of the Toradex products, you actually see the image showed here on the right side that lets you install either one of the operating systems that we've been talking about, but also demo images from our ecosystem partners. So this is a very easy way for you guys to actually evaluate all the different capabilities and the ecosystem around the new i.MX 8 QuadMax processor based on our Apalis system of modules. And we also provide part of the features of Toradex Easy Installer is also to assist you guys with your factory programming when you go into volume production. So you can use Toradex Easy Installer to actually program your finished embedded device in your factory when you're launching your products. And we have a vast, basically, database of online and offline images that you can use here for evaluation. I have a quick video here to show you how this all looks. The video will be based on our partner, the Qt company. There, we work very close with the Qt company and their application development and UI framework offering. Toradex with our SOMs and the i.MX 8 is directly supported in their tooling with the Qt for device creation tooling. So you can actually build and deploy embedded Qt applications in a really single click of a button. Let me show you that here. I'll be playing that video. So here you can see how we power up the module. It starts into Toradex Easy Installer, where you then select the boot to Qt. This will be then flashed on your onboard, flashed on the Apalis system or module. Once that's complete, it only takes a quick reboot, and your embedded board will be booting directly into the boot to Qt tooling, where you can evaluate all the rich capabilities and high performance applications. So continuing here, we will talk a little bit about the container ecosystem around Torizon. So as you learn, Torizon has a Docker container runtime. So this really allows you to quickly install and deploy demo applications, frameworks such as Qt, and in this particular case, we talk about Codesys. Codesys is an ecosystem partner who offers industrial soft PLC solutions, which are typically used in i.MX 8 industrial automation or robotics application. Now, the interesting thing is, while in the past you'd have to compile and build a custom embedded Linux image with the Codesys runtime in it, here with our Docker container from Codesys, you can simply install their runtime in with basically two lines of code. The first line is downloading the container runtime from Horizon Extra's Docker repositories. The second code line executes your container and you're ready to go and start playing with the Codesys framework. So this is actually really nice and really simplifies your time, development time frame, and also your application deployment. Another Docker container that we're offering comes from Crank Software. Crank Software, they have their storyboard suite, which is another UI development tool. Same here, you can easily download that from Docker Hub using the Torizon repository, install it with two lines, and you're ready to go and build your Crank UI framework application on i.MX. Now, another really nice market and application is, of course, AI. Pat already talked a little bit about the offering that NXP has around the i.MX 8 QuadMax processor. I'm going to highlight a couple demos and applications that we here at Toradex provide to really strengthen the ecosystem and your evaluation and development time, shorten your development time around AI at the edge. But first of all, why is i.MX 8 an ideal fit? First of all, you have a very high performance CPU cluster with the 64-bit ARMv8 cores, two A72 cores running at 1.6 gigahertz, and then another four A53 cores, 1.2 gigahertz, all with Neon extension. You also have a dual GPU cluster that supports latest OpenCL and OpenVX capabilities. And then on the sensor side, we have two quad-lane MIPI CSI camera interfaces supporting up to 8 cameras, CSI cameras, to bring in your camera feeds, in addition to, of course, typical gigabit Ethernet USB 3 or PCI Express interfaced cameras or sensors. For the camera side, we work with Allied Vision. They recently launched their new Alveon camera series, specifically targeting embedded vision. It's an industrial-grade MIPI CSI camera module, which has been actually cost-optimized, so this is a very affordable solution. And we have integrated their camera solution in one of our demo. But another AI at the edge demo application that we have comes from Xnor. Xnor is a company in Seattle. So they really focus on specializing and optimizing deep neural networks for embedded devices. Also in cases where we really have limited resources in your embedded device. This particular demo, which we have a video for, I'm playing here. There you go. So this particular demo actually features three USB 3 cameras doing a people detection demo, running three video streams, 40 frames per second, and this is all simply only CPU accelerated. So this whole demo runs only on the CPUs, on the i.MX 8 QuadMax processor. It doesn't have any GPU acceleration. So that already showcases a little bit how powerful just the CPU complexes of this particular processor. Now, one other very interesting demo, which we have been working together with Amazon and their AWS team, is basically a demo around their SageMaker and SageMaker Neon offering, which are services to optimize your neural network model. So what you can actually do is you can train a neural network in the cloud using AWS SageMaker. Then you can optimize that same model for the i.MX 8 QuadMax processor using SageMaker Neon, and then deploy that on your i.MX 8 based system of module from Toradex. Our Apalis with the i.MX 8 processor also has been fully AWS IoT Greengrass qualified. So that means you can trust that the module is fully supported by their offerings. Let's look a little bit about a demo that we actually built around all this technology. So this is our famous pasta demo. So you see a conveyor belt running simple pasta pieces under the camera. So on the top, in the middle, you see the MIPI CSI 2 camera from Allied Vision that I just talked about a little bit earlier. In the middle, you see our Apalis module with the i.MX 8 QuadMax processor, and just highlighting all the interfaces for cloud connectivity via wireless or Ethernet connectivity. We have HDMI interfaces, so you can connect up to two monitors here to actually display the feed and then use the typical embedded control algorithms for running your motors and your drives and basically run the conveyor belt. Now, we will actually be providing this entire demo as a starter kit, AI@the-edge starter kit. So you can be buying the Apalis i.MX 8 based module together with the camera and the carrier board. And you can download all the sample code from toradex.com and then basically give you a kickstart if you plan to use these technologies. Another provider for really AI at the edge type neural network applications is a company called Ozone. NXP in particular, as well as Toradex, have been working close together with Ozone and to support their DeepView toolchain. The DeepView toolchain is similar to SageMaker Neon. They provide a model to really train and deploy your AI onto your embedded device. You can find more information on our website if this is interesting for you, and we also provide a simplified evaluation around that. Finally, we're almost at the end, but before we conclude and go into Q&A, I do want to quickly talk about the last really special feature around the i.MX 8 processor. Pat already highlighted it a little bit, so you can see on the top right, the processor actually comes with two M4 microcontroller cores. They're typically being used for either real-time, low-power, or then functional safety type applications. Toradex does provide you the full FreeRTOS BSP that with the messaging stack between your Linux and your FreeRTOS. And we also have been simplifying the development around the M4 MCU cores, providing Visual Studio Code integration just to kind of ease your development environment there. One very interesting use case, as Pat already highlighted, is the functional safety application for the M4 core. We have worked together with the customer Rimac. They build some of the fastest electric cars, and they're using the i.MX 8QuadMax process with its M4 microcontrollers, developing an ACLB certified infotainment cluster dashboard in their electric cars. They use Linux and Qt on their Cortex-A application processors and use the M4 MCU doing the CRC checks on the frame buffers to actually make sure those critical warning lights on your digital cluster go on. And this has all been, they've been working directly with NXP and their Safe Assure certification program to get this developed. Now, final poll for the day. Let's have a quick look at how many of you actually are familiar and are using heterogeneous multicore processing in your current embedded projects. First votes are coming in. Give it a couple more seconds before we conclude. Let's look at the results. So we have about 1/3 of you are using or are planning to use the M4 for real-time offloading. We have about 25 of you planning to use it for safety features, with about 15% for low power, and about 1/3 of you are actually not currently using it. Thanks for sharing that. That's very useful for us. So without that, any more content to share, let's go a little bit into our Q&A session. I saw already that a lot of your questions came in. If you haven't submitted your questions, please go ahead and do that right now in your GoToWebinar panel on your computer. We have a lot of questions come in, so I will start with one of the first questions here. And Pat, I'll be actually handing that over to you. I think initially you talked about an M-marked device, about the i.MX 8QuadMax processor. I believe that was around the part numbers. Could you elaborate what your M parts are?
Yes, the M part is our mass production part numbers. Our pre-production part numbers begin with the letter P. So any parts that are marked with M are full production, and those are now orderable part numbers. That's really what I was referring to.
Perfect. Thanks for that. Then another question came in. Does the Apalis i.MX 8QuadMax based SOM provide peripheral interfaces that may not be found on the NXP MAC board? For example, it appears that the your evaluation board pad from NXP only has the HDMI interface and does not support, provide display port. So yes, we do. So the HDMI display interface on the i.MX 8QuadMax processor is a dual role interface. So you can use that in HDMI or in display port capabilities. However, it changes the circuit that you have to implement on your carrier board. So probably like NXP implemented the HDMI reference circuits, the same Toradex did, but because Toradex offers you a system of modules that lets you customize your carrier board very easily, and the carrier boards are typically very simple to customize, you can implement the display port there. I don't know, Pat, if you guys have any plans to support display port in any of your reference designs around the i.MX 8 part.
No, currently, but we have been looking at it for some of our future designs, including if we do a redesign for the Dual Max EVK. So we have been discussing that, the different options to bring out. A lot of times that's kind of, we run into physical dimension issues on exactly what ports to bring out. So that's one of them that's under discussion.
Okay, perfect. Then also a question came in about how Qt support and what version of Qt is required. So yes, in the demo video that you actually saw, Qt is supported. In particular, the commercial version of Qt with their device creation toolchain. And I believe it's version 5.12, if I'm not mistaken. But if you're using the latest Qt for device creation, you can actually select the i.MX 8QuadMax as target device and start building and deploy Qt applications. Then another question, can Codasys run on the M4? This is possible. However, our Codasys demo is based on the Cortex A core together with the real-time optimizations that we have implemented in Torizon, providing soft real-time features. So that's the current status there. Then another question came in, is Toradex Easy Installer used? Can it be used to install Torizon? And is Torizon built with Yocto? How does adding Yocto recipes and layers look like in your Toradex Yocto-based development system? I can start answering the first two questions. Yes, of course, Toradex Easy Installer is our unified tooling installing any software on the Apalis system of modules with the i.MX 8 or any of our system on modules. So you can deploy a Yocto image there, demo image, console image, minimal image, but you can also as well flash your full-blown Torizon distribution. And Torizon is built with Yocto. As I pointed out earlier, we have the same code base on the lining that we use for our Yocto project embedded Linux PSP. And with regards to the Yocto recipes and layers, we'll have to get back in detail, but we do also have documentation about that on our website. Let's go on, a couple more questions. What are the OSs supported for the M4 MCU course? So we at Toradex, we support FreeRTOS. The question, however, is AutoSAR also reported?
Yeah, we do on AutoSAR, certainly falling into our functional safety needs. We do have a team for the latest AutoSAR needs for some of the low-level drivers or other uses. And we also have MCU Expresso along with MQX as well for i.MX 8, along with FreeRTOS that we support.
Perfect. So mainly FreeRTOS and AutoSAR. Then another question for you, Pat. Is there any documentation regarding the Hi-Fi DSP available?
Yes, actually there is. We have separate app notes for Hi-Fi 4 for the DSP. And I will tell you there, to this point, have not been a whole bunch of use cases, really, because we're just launching and we're going to market with some alpha customers. But yeah, it's very software oriented, and but there is information on the Hi-Fi 4 DSP available now, and I believe it's actually if you went to the 8X family using the same DSP, I believe there's information there, and if you can't find it, just contact me directly.
Perfect. Thank you, Pat. Then another question around M4 and the interfacing. Are there any Linux drivers available in the Yocto images for interfacing with the M4 in real time? I can say yes. On the Toradex side, there is the messaging interface between the M4 cores and our FreeRTOS BSP and our Yocto images is there. Of course, in this particular case, the messaging isn't directly real-time because usually the real-time part is contained in the M4 core, but the messaging stack is fully implemented. I don't know, Pat, if you guys have anything else to add here on the BSP level.
Yeah, from a BSP level, I'm not sure if I could add much more than that. But yeah, we have had those types of use cases implementation for a lot of the communication between the M4 and the A cores using, you know, people taking advantage of these heterogeneous cores that we offer.
Correct. And via Toradex, I might add, is we have a really nice, actually we have a separate webinar about this, and we have sample code available on our website that really goes in depth into this this particular messaging between the A and the M cores. We talked about that a little bit in the past with the launch of the i.MX 7. Processor, which really kind of brought this to the mass market. And then another question is i.MX 8 or will it incorporate Microsoft's Pluton security hardware?
At this point, no. We are in discussions with Microsoft on several implementations that could take place. But yeah, currently the answer is no. For i.MX 8 core.
Okay. Another question just came in about the M4 core. Do you guys support MQX? I'm not sure, Pat, if we touched that before.
Yes, we actually do support MQX on our side.
Okay.
Along with MCU Espresso as well.
Okay. There's also a couple more questions around Qt. I won't be able to answer all of those, but one main question is, how does the roadmap look like for Qt and the Octo support around the i.MX 8? So on i.MX 8 QuadMax, a very high-end product, I believe our support level at this point is very good. Again, we at Toradex work closely together with the Qt company. The Qt company, they develop all their i.MX 8 integrations based on Toradex and NXP hardware. So if you do have any issues or questions there, make sure you can escalate to us so we can then also talk with Qt to drive that forward. On the i.MX 8X, we're a little bit behind because i.MX 8 QuadMax just launched. And I think, Pat, for the i.MX 8X, the launch is still pending, so we're also not that far ahead with our integrations.
Yeah, that launch looks to be February, late February for the 8X. And really the implementation really with similar IP should be very similar to what's going on with the 8 family, 8 QuadMax family.
Perfect. Yeah, I believe we touched most of the questions here. So with that, I would say, and for those of you which we haven't gotten to the question, we'll make sure that we get back to you via email. Also, we might not have been able to answer your questions at the low level. So again, that's something we're happy to follow up via email. So that would actually conclude our Q&A session. I would like to get just make sure if you have any more information, please reach, if you need anything more, reach out to us. Contact us, marketing@toradex.com. And once you leave today's webinar, you also receive a quick survey. We would really appreciate your feedback to make sure that we can cover the topics that interest you in the next session. And again, the recording of this webinar will be provided in about a week on toradex.com and also on our YouTube channel. So with that, I would like to thank you very much, Pat, for joining me today. And thanks everyone for attending our session. We really appreciate you all joining, and we'll see you in our next webinar.
Thanks, Sam.
Bye now.